Hi everyone, good morning. So let's begin with the class. By now, we have seen that nervous system in animals controls and coordinates their body. It does that with the help of muscular system. But what about in plants? Plants do not have nervous system or muscular system, right? So how are the movements coordinated in plants? So students, in this lesson, we will study about coordination in plants. So students, in the very first slide, we will see about coordination in plants. Here, coordination in the plants are of two types. One is growth independent and growth dependent. So all the movements in the plants that we see in our daily life are either growth independent or growth dependent movements. So first, let us see about growth independent movement. Here, name itself says it is independent. That means the movement that is not at all related to the growth. So these kind of plants are categorized under growth independent movement. You might have seen touch me not plants. You have also touched that plant, right? So what happens to the plant? Did you notice that the leaves curl whenever you touch them? Yes. Do this movement is not growth related? Plant just responded the touch. So what happened exactly? When you touch the plant sensed that touch and responded accordingly. It means plant senses the external triggers. The external trigger that causes a physiological response. This is called stimulus. You already know the definition for stimulus, right? If you observe closely, the part of the plant which is moved is different from the part of the plant which is touched. It means information from the part of the plant which is touched should be traveled to the part of the plant which is moved, right? Since we already know that plant doesn't have nervous system to carry on these transmissions, so then how do plants do this? Plants use electrochemical means to convey their message from one cell to another. I'll repeat, plants use electrochemical means to convey their message from one cell to another. Also, the question comes, right? Like, how do these movements or changing shape happens? We saw that in animals, specialized proteins present in muscles are responsible for their movement. But in plants, these movements depends on the amount of water present in the plants. When water enters the plant cell, they swell. As a result, their shape changes when caused plant movements. Then it causes a plant movement. Now let's discuss growth dependent movement in plants. Coming to the next slide, it is about growth dependent movement. You might have noticed tendrils in a pea plant. When they are touched, it is touch sensitive, right? They climb on other plants. So whenever they find a support, the part of the tendril which is towards the support, it doesn't grow. While the part of the tendril away from the supporting, it starts growing. As a result, the tendrils encircles or clings. That means it attaches to the support. In the picture, you can easily identify how the tendrils has been encircled to a wire or a stick. Okay, so another example of growth dependent movement in plants is seed germination. When the seed germinate, root goes down and shoot goes up. This directional movement of root and shoot is caused because of growth. So you can do a small activity at your home itself. Take a pot, small pot, and add few seeds. Take a ragi or a wheat. Okay, sow it, and in few days you can see the seeds has been germinating. So this type of germinating of seeds is related to growth dependent movement. These directional movements of plants in response to some stimulus are called tropic movements. So you can get a question like, what is tropic movements? So the directional movements of a plant in response to some stimulus, in response to some trigger, are said to be tropic movements. We will see it in the next slide. Okay. Yeah, just now I said the definition for tropic moments. Here is it. These directional moments of plants in response to some stimulus are called tropic moments. Depending on the kind of stimulus, these tropic moments are of many kinds. For example, first is phototropic moments or phototropism, geotropic moments or geotropism, hydrotropic moments or hydrotropism, chemotropic moments or chemotropism. So these examples are based on or depend on the kind of stimulus, okay, these moments are mentioned. We will see one by one in a upcoming slides. So here, coming to photoelectric movements or phototropism, movements of the plant, it is towards or away from the light. Name itself says phototropy. Photo means light. So the movement of the plants, it is towards or away from the light. Let's understand this by an example. If you shine a bright light towards one side of a plant, the shoot of the plant grows towards the light, while root grows away from the light. So this is about phototropic movements or phototropism. Okay, next we will see geotropic movements or geotropism. The next one is geotropic movements or geotropism. So what does definition say? Movement of the plants towards or away from a gravity, that is known as geotropic movements. Name itself says it is geotropic. Geo means earth, so it is something related to earth, that is gravity. Okay, example, movement of a root is towards the gravity while the movement of the shoot is away from the gravity. In the picture you can easily make out. Okay, next is hydrotropic movements or hydrotropism. So name itself says again, hydro means water. Okay, movement of the plants towards or away from the water are known as hydrotropic movements or hydrotropism. Example, root grows towards water. Wherever the water is present in the soil, so automatically the water attracts the root. The root starts growing towards the water. This is the example for hydrotropic movements or hydrotropism. Next, the last one is chemotropic movements or chemotropism. Again, name says chemo means chemical. That is chemical. It is towards a chemical or away from a chemical. Chemotropic movements or chemotropism. Movements of a plant towards or away from chemicals. Example, movement of a pollen tube towards ovule. As soon as the pollen grains falls on the stigma, so the pollen grains develops a pollen tube and it starts moving towards ovule. So that movement is said to be chemotropic movements because it is moving towards a chemical. So that is the reason we give this example for chemotropic movements. Fine, understood? Yeah. Now the question arises, how does this information transmitted in the body of the plant? So as we know that this information is transmitted by electrical means or by chemical means, and as plants doesn't have nervous system, so there is no electrical means of communication in plants. So plants use chemical means of communication. Now this chemical means of communication is slow, but chemicals reach all the cells as opposed to electrical signals, which reach it reach only the cells which are connected by nervous tissue. In chemical means of communication, the stimulated cells secrete chemicals which are transmitted all around the plant body. These chemicals are called hormones. So here is a basic definition for hormones, that is chemical means of communication. The stimulated cells secrete chemicals which are transmitted all around the plant body. These chemicals are called hormones. I hope everyone has followed the topic, that is about definition of hormones and growth dependent and growth independent movements and examples for tropic movements, that is phototropism, hydrotropism, chemotropism and geotropism. So learn the definitions and understand the concept based on the definition, and let me know if there's any queries. Please do text in a group and along with this worksheet will be sent. Please do solve it. Okay, see you all. Good day.